Hello, this is a demonstration of Etherblade.NET version 1 project, an universal Ethernet encapsulator hardware core. The project is implemented on Xilinx 7 series FPGA. In the first half of this video, I'll give you a high-level design overview and explain operational principles of the system. The second half is the actual demonstration of working hardware that has been developed during the course of this project. So let's start. Etherblade.NET version 1 project is about development of encapsulator hardware core. This core essentially is a module that receives VLAN tagged Ethernet frame via its input interface, prepends or encapsulates it with an outer header, and after that sends encapsulated datagram via its output interface. The encapsulator core is equipped with headers memory that is split into 16 regions. Each region of that memory corresponds to a particular VLAN and contains outer header for that VLAN. In order to make this presentation more intuitive, frames and headers belonging to different VLANs are depicted in different colors. When VLAN-tagged Ethernet frame arrives via input interface, it gets fully accepted and stored inside the core in dedicated buffer memory. Then it gets prepended with a corresponding outer header from headers memory. And finally, produced datagram leaves the block via output interface. In a similar way, frames belonging to other VLANs get prepended with corresponding headers. On this particular slide, we see a purple frame being prepended with the purple header. Frames belonging to green VLAN get prepended with corresponding green header, and so on. The design of the encapsulator core is based on modified store and forward buffer. It encapsulates frames autonomously at line rate speed with no CPU or software involvement. In order to make the encapsulator core start doing its job, one small problem needs to be solved. The problem is when the system powered up, the headers memory of the core contains no data. Obviously, encapsulating Ethernet frames with outer headers, which are just series of zeros, will not be useful, so we must find a way to fill headers memory with relevant data. Thanks to FPGA technology, we can easily integrate our encapsulator core with a microprocessor subsystem and other peripherals within single system-on-chip design. Now we can run a software inside FPGA, and by interfacing with this software via RS-232 port, we can make processor subsystem program the encapsulator core. And this is how it works. We have specially formatted microcode that contains necessary header information for a particular VLAN. This microcode we supply to the processor subsystem via RS-232 port. The software running on the microprocessor extracts low-level data from the microcode. And the processor system uses this data to program corresponding VLAN region in the headers memory of the core. Okay, this was a theoretical introduction, and now we can move to the hardware demonstration. At the beginning of the demonstration, we start with empty headers memory. Then we supply microcode commands for VLAN 1 to make all the frames belonging to VLAN 1 being encapsulated with Ethernet and MPLS headers. Then we will supply microcode commands for VLAN 2 to make all the frames belonging to VLAN 2 being encapsulated with Ethernet, IPv4 and GRE headers. And finally, we'll supply microcode for VLAN 3. And this will make the system encapsulate all the frames belonging to VLAN 3 with Ethernet, IPv6 and GRE headers. Here is the setup of the demonstration lab. The router that will be generating frames for different VLANs is connected to the input Ethernet interface of the FPGA board. On the output interface of the FPGA board, we have our PC with Wireshark sniffer program running. By using Wireshark, we will be capturing datagrams produced by the encapsulator core. On the control side of things, we will have two other applications running on the PC. First is the terminal client. This would allow us to supply microcode to the FPGA processor subsystem. And the second is the app that will let us log in and manage the router. Now, we are going to jump on the PC and continue our demonstration from there. So, we have microcode commands prepared in advance in this Excel document. These commands are split into three sets, where each set can encode an outer header for a particular VLAN. To make the router generate frames for VLAN 1, 2, and 3, we need 3 IP sub-interfaces configured and 3 static ARP records for destination IP addresses in these VLANs. In our case, the router will generate frames for VLAN 1 if we ping 10.33.1.1 address. It will generate frames for VLAN 2 if we ping 10.33.2.1 address. And frames for VLAN 3 if we ping 10.33.3.1 address. Now, let's start generating frames for VLAN 1. While the router is busy generating the traffic, we can open Wireshark and see how the encapsulated datagrams look like. The first 64 bytes being zeros is the outer header produced by the core. And the rest of the datagram is the original encapsulated Ethernet frame generated by the router. In the original Ethernet frame, we can see Ethernet type 8100, indicating that the frame is VLAN tagged, and we can also see VLAN tag itself. Now, we can start feeding microcode to FPGA for VLAN 1 and see how that will change the content of the outer header. Let's start with supplying a part of the microcode that defines Ethernet header only. Then we open Wireshark and see that the outer header has defined Ethernet part now. Let's supply remaining MPLS part of the microcode to the FPGA. And see how encapsulated datagrams look like with the full Ethernet and MPLS headers. Now, let's start generating frames for VLAN 2. As you remember, we need to ping 10.33.2.1 address to do this. Let's see that the Wireshark can capture encapsulated datagrams. In order to transform the outer header into something meaningful, we have to supply our microcode to the FPGA. As we did for the previous VLAN, let's do Ethernet part first. And now we can observe the change in the Wireshark. Let's supply IPv4 part of the outer header now. And see that the encapsulated datagram has defined IPv4 header. Finally goes the GRE part of the outer header. So we supply it to the FPGA and see how the whole outer header looks like when it contains Ethernet, IPv4, and GRE parts. Wireshark is indicating that there is a problem with length and checksum fields in IPv4 header. This is because the arithmetical logic inside the core that calculates these values requires some supplementary data in order to produce correct results. So we have this data prepared in advance in our Excel document as well. So we just supply it to the FPGA to get this data written in the corresponding encapsulator registers. And now we can see that the core is calculating these fields correctly. Let's increase the length of generated layer 2 frames. This is to show that the encapsulator can still produce IPv4 headers with correct checksum and length fields. And yes, it does, as we are still able to observe clean Wireshark output. Now, let's start generating frames for VLAN 3. In order to do this, we need to ping 10.33.3.1 address. We can see that the datagrams are prepended with empty headers. Let's feed microcode to FPGA for VLAN 3. We start with the microcode defining Ethernet part of the outer header. Let's observe the change in Wireshark. Let's apply IPv6 header. And see how encapsulated datagrams arrive with complete IPv6 part defined. Finally is the GRE part of the outer header. Let's apply it to FPGA. And see how the whole outer header looks like when it contains Ethernet, IPv6 and GRE parts. IPv6 header has no checksum field, but Wireshark is indicating the problem with the length. Let's fix length error by programming corresponding VLAN 3 register with pre-calculated length data. Now we can see that length errors are gone. Let's change the length of generated layer 2 frames. To make sure that encapsulator will still be producing correct length field in IPv6 header. And yes, after the change, Wireshark output is still looking fine. At the end of this video, let me make the router generate frames for all three VLANs simultaneously. In the Wireshark, we can see that they are encapsulated with corresponding programmed headers. But what if we want to change, let's say, destination IPv6 address in the outer header for VLAN 3? We can just simply reprogram memory address and headers memory with corresponding data. Let me show how to amend a microcode command for it. And send this new microcode command to the processor subsystem in FPGA. The embedded software overrides the value in the core memory, and we can see that the destination IPv6 address in the header has changed. So, this is the end of this demonstration video. You shall feel free to use this hardware core in your project, whether you want to embed it in your own system-on-chip design, port to a different FPGA board, write your own management software, or couple it with Linux operating system. If you're interested in this development and open for collaboration, please get in touch, and thanks for watching.